पुल अप एंड पुल डाउन रेसिस्टर्स। पुल अप एंड पुल डाउन रेसिस्टर्स आर यूज्ड टू मेंटेन प्रॉपर लॉजिक लेवल्स एट द इनपुट पिन्स अंडर ऑल कंडीशंस। पुल अप रेसिस्टर यूज्ड टू पुल अप द वोल्टेज इनटू द लॉजिक हाई। If the pull-up resistor is not connected, that is value goes to floating state. Similarly, pull-down resistor is used to pull down the voltage to the logic low. So here, if the switch is closed, the VCC voltage coming to the ground. When switch is open, whatever the VCC voltage is there, that is coming to the input pin through pull up resistor. These here the input values may be logic high, logic zero, or when these are not connected, pull up or pull up resistors, these values are high impedance state. These can be enabled. Pull up resistors and pull down resistors can be enabled by setting the logic one in the resistor enable resistor. So if you look at here, so whenever a resistor is enabled, the value is zero means that indicating the pull down resistor, one indicating the pull up resistor. Like that, by setting the values in the resistor enable, we can enable the pull up resistor and pull down resistors. So here when switch is closed, the voltage is coming to the P2.1. when switch is open, the VCC voltage is coming to the ground. These pull up and pull down resistors are used to interfacing with external devices with the microcontroller pins, or this may be used in interfacing with analog to digital converters, external peripherals, or external peripherals. Example, so program to light LED when button B1 is pressed. Let D1 LED 1 is connected to the P2.3 active low circuit, that one, and push button is connected at P2.1 with internal pull up resistors enabled. So for this, first we need to connect port 2 to third pin for LED, for connecting the LED 1. Similarly, port 2 to first pin for connecting with push button. P2.3 is active low circuit, so we are giving 0 to switch on the LED 1. Similarly, we are giving 1 to switch on the push button since it is active high circuit. So first, hash include msp430.h, which indicating a library file. Next, void main function, which indicates start of the program. Next, stop the watchdog timer to avoid the resetting the system for every 32 milliseconds. For that, by using watchdog timer controller, CTL means controller, watchdog timer control equal to watchdog timer hold using password. PW means password. After entering the password, we can give the hold value to the control pin. Like that, we can stop the watchdog timer. Next, we need to select port 2, bit 1, pin 1 and pin 3 as the input and output pins. So for that, we are using the instruction P2 select. By using P2 select, we can select the port 2 and pin 1 and 3. These are active low circuits, so we are giving complement values. So to operate as the GPIO pins, we are giving complement values. 0 means GPIO pins, 1 means alternative functions. Since these are output pin LED, push button is input pin. So these are IO pins, so we are giving complement here to operate as the general purpose input and output pins. Next, after selecting the IO pins, we need to select which one is input, which one is output, like that. For that, we can use the instruction P2DIR, that means port to direction, that bit 3 is 1 indicates the output pin, 0 indicates the input pin. That's why port to DIR, P2DIR vertical strip, bit 3, that indicates the third port to third pin as the output pin. Similarly, port to bit 1, that indicates the input pin, that is switch. Next, then we need to enable the pull up resistors here. For that, we are using the port to resistor enable instruction. Port to resistor enable. So, port to resistor enable, that resistor is connecting to the pin 1, that is switch. So, we are interfacing this MSP430 with the push button through the pull up resistor. That's why we are giving here complement value. Next, port to output pin equal to port to output and complement. So select the pull up resistor. So by giving the 0, by giving the 0, that is the pull up resistor for port 2.1. Next, since LED 1 is active low pin, initially that value is 1, that means off condition. Since it is active low, 0 means 1, 1 means 0, complement value, active low pin. So initially we are switch off, by default it is in off condition. At that time that value is 1, that's why preloading the default value. So PT out equal to P port to output pin, that is value is 1, that indicating the LED in off condition. So next we are taking for loop to repeat the continuously this operation. Next, if the port to input pin 1 is 0, that means switch, pin 1 indicates the switch. We are connecting the pin 1 to the switch through the pull up resistor. If the switch is 0, means this is active low pin. So if switch is on, next, port to output pin, pin 3, that is also active low. So that is will be on. When it will be on, means whenever we are giving 0, LED will be on, because it is active low circuit. Else, that is in off condition. So to switch off that LED, we are giving 1 here. Like that, we can switch on the LED. Our requirement is switch on the LED when push button is pressed. Since this is active low circuit, whenever we are giving logic low or 0 value to that input, at that time that LED will be on. 0 means 1, 1 means 0 here.